नई सुबह, एक और नया दिन और एक और नई सफलता हम सब के नाम, लक्ष्य के नाम। सिलेक्टेड इन SSB फॉर NDA, ऑल्सो फॉर TES, वेलकम हिम विद होप, विद इंस्पिरेशन, विद हैप्पीनेस, wishing him all the best and wishing you all the best, and in your heart and mind think that you also will be sitting here one day. Ab main nahi bolunga iske aage, he will tell you as to what he learned here, how it helped him in the SSB, and you will see that जो ये बात करेंगे तो आपको समझ में आएगा कि यार ऐसा कुछ तो मेरे अंदर भी है, ऐसा कुछ तो मैं भी यहां सीख रहा हूं। और सिंपल तरीका SSB को पार करने का, सरल तरीका, सच्चा तरीका, बिना कोचिंग के तरीका, अच्छे से जीवन जीने के बाद SSB को फतेह करने का तरीका यही है, सत्यमेव जयते। पहले अच्छे तो बनो। He will tell you how he did it. मैं बोलूंगा तो मेरी बातें तो आप सुनते ही रहते हो, इनसे थोड़ा ज्यादा अच्छा लगेगा। Over to you.
My name is Manjeet Singh Thakur. As sir told, I'm recommended for ND143 and TS42. I was here in July for a 14-day course for Lakshya Kanna. I heard about Lakshya Kanna from a friend of mine in college. So basically, I'd come here. I was very ill prepared for the SSB. I had a little bit of idea about SSB. I read some books and heard from my father's in the army. He's currently a major in the Indian Army. And so when I came here, there was some. It didn't look like a classroom to it. It was more of a consortium of ideas over here, where people gather here to exchange ideas and learn from each other. That's how we used to interact over here. And the class is quite big now. At my time here, there were only 22 to 25 students more at most. The most important thing I learned about, as you must be learning, is 5 VRCC. And that best part to me is the role-playing part, where you can learn to become a better human and apply to that more to your life rather than this SSB. Because in Lakshya Academy, it's more about becoming a better human, and becoming a more suitable candidate is a later part. Because if you become a better human, that is automatically what the army requires. Some key aspects that helped me in the SSB interviews will be, first of all, dividing every section, everything into 5 parts. That is a very important part, because you have to be more detailed and more organized in your ideas. So whenever you're getting interview, whenever you're getting your TATs, you have to be more organized. Organization is very important. So whenever you write a story, you have to divide it into 5 parts, or write at least three to four steps how you will solve it. Those are some key and small things which help you become a better candidate for SSB. Apart from that, I would say brainstorming is a very important part. I understand that you must be attending R.S. Kakkar's class. We used to get quite sleepy in his class. That's some of you must be having that same feeling too. But it is important to be attentive in that class, because those ideas automatically go in your subconscious mind, and when the interviewer asks you questions, they automatically come in front of you. And you never realize when you will learn them. So that is very important. You have to be attentive in that area. Brigadier Gurbansh Singh is a very amazing teacher. You will never get bored in his class. He always gives you creative and important knowledge, which will further help you in the future. I would say role playing is the best part that you will learn here. Whenever we used to go out in our recesses, we used to look at things and we used to discuss how we can improve it. You should do that, because it will help you become more creative and more of a better person, more of a solution oriented, which is the key to becoming a better candidate for the SSB. Also, I would say connectivity helps you become more creative, and also in WET, which is quite an important part of SAI, connectivity is very important for that, because you have to connect, and secondly, you have to connect a word with something solution oriented, something more related to development. That is very important. And the best thing I would say that I learned here is honesty. That is a very important thing, and sir will always emphasize on that topic. And I will share a part of my SSB was that I had gone for my 3 FSB board, which is a board for Air Force, and I was not interested in Air Force, but my father had forced me to go to Air Force. So So when the interviewer asked me that why do you want to join the Air Force, I told him that I don't want to join the Air Force, I rather want to join the Indian Army. So he asked me why you want to join the Indian Army, then why had you come here. So I told him the whole story, that my father had forced me. Again the GTO asked me why do you want to join Indian Air Force. I told him I want to join the Indian Army. In the end, when the conference day was there, the president asked me that are you the candidate who don't want to join the Indian Air Force, and I said yes. And they said then we will not recommend you from here, because since you don't want to join the Indian Air Force, then why should we waste the opportunity? Please go and attempt for an Indian Army SLB. Yet I got recommended because of my honesty. So I would say whenever you go to these boards, you have to be honest. Honesty is most important. You don't try to cheat the system. It has been there for 59 years, more than 59 years. It is a very well-planned and well-organized system. It will take the crux out of you. So you have to be very honest. If they caught you lying, you will never be recommended.
Okay, so before you ask, I'll ask some question, because in the flow he has very beautifully encapsulated the whole thing in very short time. But still I ask you, you were telling about role play, that role play really helped you. So you would like to share your views on that?
Yes, role play is not about related to SSB, it was related to life, more related to become a better person. When I learned about role play, I was more disciplined towards my routine, I was more organized. And I put effort in various things which I was very careless towards or lazy towards. Some aspects that has to be important, that has to be changed, and like you should work on them. Role playing helps you become more creative and more of a better citizen. It's not about just becoming a better candidate, it's about becoming a better citizen or better human. That is very important, and through role play you can achieve that. That's
okay. So you also said that there were some shortcomings that you corrected on your own after coming here, identified them and improved upon them. How did that happen?
Yes, my biggest shortcoming when I had come here in the Lakshya Academy was that I was quite dominant in a group discussion and in all group activities. It was pointed out by UBS, whenever we used to PPTTs and group discussions. So I worked upon them and I focused on my words, because wordings are very important. Your words carry a lot of weight when you say them. So you have to be very careful when you use your words. So I focus on my word, remain calm, and I focus more into others' ideas and working upon them and thinking about them. That helps you become a better at interaction, and also helps you learn new things about others.
Okay, so you said that, how did you improve upon it? You said, did you improve in the SSB or here or somewhere else?
After I left from the academy, I knew what were my shortcomings, what were my good things. So I worked upon my shortcomings in the period between my SSB and all, when I left the academy.
So basically in life with friends, relatives, family, there when he was telling me that there he improved upon it, like he just shared.
Yes, I discussed with my friends. I used to interact with my friends because as I stay in an army hostel. So a lot of cadet students who wish to join the academy. So we used to conduct mock group discussions and all, and they used to focus being more receptive towards others rather than being dominant.
Yeah. So leader is one who identifies his problems, weaknesses, accepts them, has the courage to accept them and work on them. That is, we are all work in progress. Leadership is also same. So you have to work on yourself. So that is how. You're also saying that about TAT, sorry, SRT, you were saying something. Like to share with them?
Yes, SRT is, I would say, quantity is not that as much as quality. So here I learned that you should give at least 3 to 4 steps of solution when you're giving SRT. First thing you will always learn is that you should look at the invisible. There will be a simple sentence, but there are 10 to 15 to 20 to 100 things attached to it which you can use to solve the situation. So you have to be more open-minded, more creative towards your idea. And when I gave my first SRT, I could only attempt 37, yet I got recommended. And there were many who gave 62, 60, 55. I was able to look at some other sheet and you saw that they used to write, they were writing only one sentence, whereas I was writing 3 sentences. 3 to 4 steps are very important. They show that you are detailed towards the situation, you are understanding it more carefully, and you are more organized towards your ideas.
Okay, so incidentally, we just discussed it about 10 minutes ago, about half an hour ago, same thing. And he has just copied that. And I'm sure when you understand the logic, and when you see this example here in front of you, you will be very clear about what we are talking about. See the invisible. There is a lot to be understood. Leaders can see what others cannot. Leaders can see the invisible. Leaders can see beyond the physical. So when you see the invisible also, then you understand the situation in completeness. And then there are so many resources with you to take action. There are so many aspects that you can take care of. And as he said, quality. 60 bad SRTs are no good. 40 good SRTs are better. If I give you a task, I say, din mein ye char kaam karke lao. Charo kaam karke liya hai bekar ke, koi fayda nahi na. Teen kaam kare, but achhe kare. Much better. And chautha bhi jab time milega, kar denge. So that is how. So logic and example. I gave you the logic in the morning. Here is the example. So when you do any discussion with anybody, first you give logic and then give you the example. It becomes more convincing and hard-hitting. So anything you all want to ask, a couple of questions we can take. Though most of it he has covered, but still if you have questions, please ask. Raise your hand, then we'll nominate. Yeah.
Where did your inspiration came from to join the armed forces and what was the reason behind?
Well, my inspiration, basically I was not interested in the Indian Army as till my 11th. I was interested in more of computer-related things. But my father is from the Indian Army, that always plays a role in inspiring you. Apart from that, I'm more interested in joining the Special Forces because I find them one of the best at what they do. And getting into Special Forces is something that gives me satisfaction of achieving the highest potential that I could ever.
Okay, this motivation is always self. It doesn't come from your father or your mother, though they are contributing to it. But the real motivation is your own self. So your consciousness, your body and mind, your thoughts, how you perceive the world, and then you motivate yourself. Remember that you will motivate yourself. That is the real motivation. So very well answered. Anybody else? Yeah.
Sir, you have presented everything so beautifully. I just wanted to know, like, what are all the things that you have covered in your daily routine to think like an officer and inculcate those qualities into it, sir?
I think the only single word is that you have to be social solution oriented. That is the most important aspect when you have to think like an officer, because an officer is creative, he is more social, interactive, solutionary, he is going towards change, development. So being solution oriented automatically forces you to be more creative, more detailed, more organized towards your routine, more how you can change the routine, how you can improve it more, how you can make it more productive. So that being solution oriented is the basic key to being a better person and an officer.
Adding to him further, a leader is a status changer. Status quoist can never be a leader. He changes the status all the time. Now what is status? It is not social status. That means present condition, present situation. So anything around him, he brings a change because he wants to go to the next level. And to go to the next level, he will find some challenges. You have to be goal-oriented, you have to be solution-oriented, you will be creative to meet those challenges, status will change. Small, big, medium, whatever. So that is how you keep bringing it. And that is how, if you can make out from his replies, whatever has been going on here, he has imbibed that and he has improved upon that, brought a change in life. He was very dominating, as he said, but he realized the leader has the courage to accept and work on it. No? So very beautifully put and very good questions you people are asking. Yeah, you wanted to ask something.
Yes, sir. Sir, you said that about your dominant attitude, like what you did to control it?
Well, basically you have to just keep a focus on your own behavior. As I said, your words carry a lot of weight. So there are some words which, some sentences that create a lot of difference between being dominant and being receptive. So for example, when I gave my ideas in group discussions, I used to end with, you all agree? I hope you all agree. So that says that I'm already giving my statement that I want you all to agree. Whereas Sir pointed at saying that rather than saying I hope you all agree, you should say do you all agree. So that's you are asking them, you're not hoping, you're commanding them to agree. So that is, so these words, these small words carry a lot of weight. Apart from that, when you practice discussions, focus on yourself, focus on your ideas and be more receptive. So when you go in your SSB, you might not get a chance. It is very, as we say, it's like more like a fish market. So be receptive, maintain your calm, and look at the moment. When everyone is silent, then put your point. Everyone will focus on you. That's the best time to put your point for.
Okay, so very well said. He's basically saying that the words are the result of your thoughts. but sometimes we use them. So if your thoughts are dominating, the words will also come out like that. But sometimes we are not thinking like that, but are we using the words without thinking? So you must understand that what this could mean, what other is going to think about it. If the same word is told to me, how will I think that? It's called empathy, putting yourself into other shoes. Leaders put themselves in other shoes. That is how they understand others' problems, emotions, feelings, and take care of them. That's what he did, and there were such examples. But it's not just one. There were, when you consistently do, then you say, ye to garbad kar raha hai, bar bar kar raha hai. So he gave you one example, they were like others, and he worked on it. So I think that sums it all, and very beautifully put, very beautifully asked, and I'm very proud of him, I'm very proud of you all, because I am seeing a lot of selection here in this batch also. Once again.